Hey, First Baptist Norfolk. Hey, Pastor Eric. Happy New Year. I think I'm not too late, right? I'm not too late. So just to give you a quick update about us, me, my wife, my three daughters, honestly, we're doing great. Usually in holidays, we go visit families. Our families and friends, but we weren't able to do that. So we enjoyed ourselves. I enjoyed my wife, she enjoyed me, we enjoyed our children. That was great. Normally we don't do that, but that was just great. As far as community, we were able to do so many projects during the holidays. We had a week called, Love Our City, our City Week. So we were able to do 150 cards for a retiring home for the elderly people. We actually saw on the social media elderly people with a, kind of a poster saying, hey, would you write me a card? So we just answered to that need. We did 30 Christmas cards for a mentally challenged home as well with symbols so that they were able to read the cards. And we participated in their community reunion that they were doing via Zoom. So that was quite an experience, an awesome experience. We were able to do about 20 food baskets for homes. And that was quite of a blessing because we were expecting one box because we kind of connected with a food bank that provided us with the food and everything, and they promised a box of food, but we ended up having three boxes of food per family. So that was just great. Lots of volunteer people just participating in the projects. And we're talking about people from our church, friends of people from our church, non-believer friends of people from our church. So we see how the projects were impacting not only the beneficiary, the people that we were aiming, but just the volunteers. So that was quite an experience, and that was really, really awesome. And I think for us, 2020, it's been a great blessing because we've seen lots of people just joining our church. So we see new faces. So that's quite a blessing. And the lady that's in charge of our Love City Week, within a month, okay, a month and a half, she was involved. She connected with her church maybe 4 months before Christmas. And she was really low key. And then a month and a half maybe before Christmas, we had a talk because I saw that she had potential and everything, but she was wounded by the church. And she accepted the call to take responsibility for the projects, and the community involvement. And she is the bomb. She's just awesome. She's awesome. She's fully involved, fully devoted, praying for the people. And her leadership is impacting other people. And we have in our Saint Cassette, which was our small kind of prayer Bible study meeting, we see more people attending and we see people maturing in Christ. I'm thinking about Tamara. Tamara, I love her story because it's typical, it's up and down. One week she says, I'm not sure if I believe anymore. And the other week, oh, God's been answering my prayers. And we see that all the time. Just please continue praying for us. Thank you so much for your generosity. COVID or not, God is building his church in the Ottawa Gatineau speaking community. And for myself, I just want to do my goal. Pray for me. I just want to be a pastor. That's it. Whatever. COVID, no COVID. I just want to be a pastor for the sheep. I just want to be a good husband. I just want to be an example to show Christ. Please pray for me. Pray for my family. Pray for our community. I love you guys. I hope I wasn't too long. Love you guys. Bye-bye.